creatine.
Great study in menopausal women helping with depression. So we know it helps with cognition, it helps with bones, it helps with skin, it helps you work out harder. And I have been amazed because as I've been talking about creatine, I have gotten so much resistance that I'm blown away. Like, I have gotten more feedback on this supplement than anything else ever.
Is it the water retention weight gain concern is the big one for women?
It is. Some of that fluid retention's amazing.
It's in the muscle, right?
Goes back to, you got to use a bioimpedance scale because then you'll go, oh, this is awesome. Mm. I have more water in my muscles. And I don't know about you, but when I started taking creatine, I'm like, where has this been all my
life? Put some creatine in there.
Why? Tell us about it.
Oh my gosh. So creatine is more important for women than men. So women have 70 to 80% less tissue stores of creatine than men do. Creatine is something that is going to help us work out harder, recover faster, can help with muscle, can help with bone density, can help with our mood. In fact, they did a study on postmenopausal women, and they found that when they gave them creatine, it was more effective than just giving them like an antidepressant alone. So it helps with cognition, it helps with depression, it helps with skin wrinkling.
What?
I know. Your smoothie.
Ladies, listen, I'm going to talk to you about what I can talk about creatine. There's a lot of fitness influencers out there pretending they're doctors, and they're going to tell you about the cognitive benefits. They're going to tell you about how it's going to help you with hormones and menopause. And while I read the reports and that is all true, I'm not a doctor to tell you that, hey, this is what this is about. But I do know that I've been taking creatine on and off for the last 20 years. And I do want to talk about a couple of them. First and foremost, if you've been taking supplements like me and you've been around the block, supplements come and go, but there's certain supplements that stay. There's a reason why creatine stays is because it works, and I feel it work. And it's one of the few supplements you can see and feel it working, which is the best part. In terms of performance, here's what I've noticed that we've done, and this is how it's going to help you. Now, if you're taking creatine and you're relatively new to creatine and you're new to training, you're taking it for all the benefits that we've already talked about that I'm not an expert on, like menopause and hormones and obviously getting you through different parts of your day with better cognitive function, those are great. But if you want to talk about performance, you're going to notice it more when you start to get to that point where you plateau. Now, when you first come in, you get gains right away. Your body adjusts, it, you know, puts under stress, you recover, and then you rest, and then boom, and your fibers get thicker, denser, and you become stronger, faster, and you become a lot more fit quickly. But you do plateau after a while, and this is where this helps you break through that plateau. So there's this myth that it causes water retention, and it's kind of true, but it's not. Let's talk about the water retention. What creatine does is it pulls muscle in, so water into the muscle. So this would be your muscle now, right? I just want to give you a visual. It's kind of flat and everything else. When you take creatine, you have more water in the muscle. It's fuller, right? And that's going to give you more tone, physically fit look, which I absolutely love. What most people, I guess, would picture it as is that with night when you have maybe some pizza, some wings, some bad food, salty food, and you feel like water retention on the outside. You can feel it in your skin. You can feel it everywhere. You just don't feel good and you feel puffy. This doesn't make you puffy. Now, the other thing too is it accentuates your energy sources while you train. So you have primary energy sources when you train, and these energy sources, after they slow down, it impedes your performance because you can only do things for so long to recruit certain types of muscle fibers. When you use that creatine, it enhances that and allows that performance to go on for a little bit longer. So if you're out there and you're training and you're failing maybe at 12 reps, 13 reps, with creatine, that'll get you to 14, 15, 16 reps, which now puts more load on the muscle, more stress on the muscle. The muscles recover, the muscles come back a little bit denser, thinner. And what happens is you start to put on a little bit more muscle mass, you start to have more energy, you start to be able to perform a lot better. And at the end of the day, if you're going through a plateau, this is the great way to plateau and you will feel the difference. That's the part. I brought all the creatine in for everybody. So if you're out there and you're interested in creatine, go ahead and read the article that I put it there for you. It's all about the research that's being done on creatine, and it's one of the few supplements I stand by. Boom.